Hey guys, welcome to our second episode of Shadowloo Bootcamp. My name is Mono, and today we're gonna cover Bison's combos. We're gonna do from the most basic combos to his more advanced, all leading up to V-trigger combos. Okay, so before we start off with episode 2 of Shadowloo Bootcamp, there was a recent video that I posted up that actually got a lot of buzz in Twitter of a Bison reset that I did, that Justin retweeted it. So thanks to Justin for the support and for everybody else who saw it and retweeted and sent messages. I'm gonna show you the clip if you haven't seen it. I'm gonna show the clip right now, and then we're gonna go on with the combo video, with the combo guide for Bison. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed that little clip of the Bison recent that I just showed. If you had not seen it, well, hope you liked it. If you enjoy the tech, be sure to follow because there's a lot more tech to come. Before the video starts, I want to be clear on something. We're also going to have the sections that we're going to cover on an annotations on the side of the video. We're going to cover sections like normal combos, counter hit combos, meaty combos, V-trigger combos, and on the description below, you'll also have the timestamps. So you can also redirect yourself to the section that you want to see. So let's do this. Let's get started. Before we start with all the combos that I'm going to go over throughout this whole episode, I want you guys to know something very important with Bison. There are certain moves that you can't cancel into his specials. I'm just going to go through them over them right now really quick so that you know. His crouching light kick, you can't cancel it. You can't cancel it into scissor kick. You can't cancel it into anything. You can't cancel his stand strong, stand medium punch. You can't cancel it into anything. His down forward fierce can't be canceled. That was his far fierce. See, you can't cancel. Sweep can't be canceled, and his stand medium kick cannot be canceled either. And his crouching fierce punch cannot be canceled either. Into anything. All these moves, even though they cannot be canceled into special moves, they can be canceled into the trigger. That's the only thing you can do with those moves. So that's very important to know, and now we're gonna go off with the combos. Okay guys, we're gonna start off with M.Bison combos. I'm gonna go with the most basic, like I'm gonna start from low attacks up until mediums, then heavies, and all the way up to the trigger combos, so that you guys can know what combos to do off of what normals which you start off, okay? Depending on the starter. So I'm gonna go in training mode. We're gonna pick Bison. And I'm gonna pick Ken. He's default. Hurt boxes in this game aren't really too significant with regards to range and combos. Like they're pretty much every combo hits on everyone. Few exceptions. So I'm gonna start with low attacks, combos with low attacks. Now, Bison's lows, they all come out in four. So first combos, gonna do two hit combos into a special move. You got that one, which is crouching low punch into standing low punch into a psycho blast. That's a good confirm, you get two lows, and then you do that. But the thing is that you can block this either high or low, so it's not really, it's not good to open people up. Like you do a dash and like they react late. So a better combo would be crouching low kick, crouching jab into low psycho blast. So that's a three hit combo and it's a low. Other than that, you can do another one that's good for scissor kick pressure is crouching jab into standing short into low scissor kick. The low scissor kick has significant startup, so you can't combo it off crouching jab, and you can't combo it off standing jab. You can only combo low scissor kick after a standing short. So you have to make sure that whatever combo you do, if you start up from the low, you have to finish with a low kick if you want the scissor kick. And so he has three hit confirms, which is even better. You can do this one, which is starting from a low. That is crouching short, crouching jab, standing short into low scissor kick. Now, the good thing about the short is that you can do either, you can do the low kick scissor kick and that leaves you in plus, so that's really good. You can also do EX, you can let, this is something that you should know. EX pretty much has a fast startup, more or less like the low scissor kick. You can either do stand, finish with stand jab into EX scissor kick, or that was standing jab, right? Or you can do stand short, whichever you prefer. If you're already used to standing short, well then just do stand short, because it's pretty much the same range. Now, in the corner, that doesn't hit. If you do two shorts into Psycho Blast, that doesn't hit. So that's pretty much all the combos you can do off his lows. That's pretty much it. If you do a cross up, you can't, you shouldn't do the three lows. You can do them. See, I did there, jump, medium, kick. You can pretty much do the same ones, like jump, medium, kick. Jump, medium, kick, crouching short, crouching jab, standing short, which is the same one that I was doing here. You can do it if you do it close. See? So pretty much after a crossover, I would recommend that you do a two hit confirm actually, because sometimes you hit the cross up too far and it might whiff, depends. So I usually do, I'll just go for two. I'll do crouching jab, see? Crouching jab, stand short into scissor kick, and it leaves you close. And you can go for the throw, you walk up throw. So it's really good. Now if you want like higher damage, you can do into super, like critical arts. You could do, see, you can cancel that into super. Did it wrong, sorry guys. There we go. I mean, it's decent damage. The only problem is that, like I said, you do crouching jab, you can block that high, you can block that low. I mean, it's not really an opener. But if you do the long confirm, if you do that, the super doesn't hit because of the distance. See? Leaves you too far. Now, another combo that you can do from shorts, from low attacks into super, is in the corner. And this one, to me, is the better one. Which is, you do crouching short, crouching jab, low psycho blast, and psycho crusher. And that one's good because it comes from a low, like you can confirm it off a low. Which is better. Now, okay, that covers low attacks when he's not in V-Trigger. When I get to V-Trigger, I'm gonna explain, because V-Trigger actually changes a lot of his special moves and some combos don't hit. So now I'm gonna move to the medium attacks, his combos with mediums, and then I'll go with heavy attacks as well. Basically with Bison, you have his cancelable normals are his crouching medium kick and his crouching strong, his crouching medium punch. Now, with crouching medium kick, I want to cover something here, and I want to be clear with it and very specific, because it's a problem that a lot of Bison players from Street Fighter 4 to Street Fighter 5, I did it, I made the mistake when I was playing him. His crouching medium kick doesn't have enough hit stun, and since his scissor kicks have a lot more startup, you can't combo medium scissor kick after a medium kick. Like, if you do crouching medium kick into medium scissor kick, Ken gets the block. In Street Fighter 4, you could do crouching medium kick into roundhouse scissor kick. But in this game, since the medium kick has less hit stun and the scissor kick has more startup, well, you can only do either crouching medium kick into low scissor kick or crouching medium kick into EX scissor kick, because they're both relatively fast. So make sure not to make that mistake when you're playing with Bison, because I know it's a really hard habit to take away because of Street Fighter 4. Another thing with his crouching medium kick is that you cannot combo his medium inferno. I did, that was crouching medium punch. But you can't combo it off your crouching forward, and you can't combo the EX either. You can only do the low version. after crouching medium kick. Same goes for his Psycho Blast. You can't combo his medium Psycho Blast, you can only combo his low. So keep that in mind when you're using this his crouching forward. I would recommend that you use more his crouching strong, but obviously crouching forward hits low, so that's some pretty significant reason to use it as well. Now, his crouching strong, you can do basically the same combos you can do with crouching medium kick, except he can actually do medium into medium. Like, you can do crouching medium punch into medium scissor kick, and the thing that's good about that is that you're even closer when you finish after a medium scissor kick. You can do crouching medium punch into medium flame, medium inferno, psycho inferno, or into EX inferno, also combos. And you can do crouching medium punch into medium psycho blast. So you get to do a bit more damage with Bison when you use his crouching medium punch. Now, a link, he has a link, which is two mediums. You can do, this is a combo that he has standing medium into crouching medium. Now, that's pretty much your go-to combo, relatively every time. If you get a cross-up, you can do crouching stand medium into crouch medium into scissor kick, or into flame. See? But if you do the Psycho Blast, it doesn't reach. See? You're too far. Now, his combos, well, stand medium punch into crouch medium punch, then you can do either stand medium punch into crouching medium punch into medium flame, or you can do EX Flame for more damage. Same goes for the scissor kicks. And like I said earlier, you can't, after this combo, you can't do his Psycho Blast because you're too far. Now, his combos that do good damage are crushing medium into his crouching medium into medium scissor kick into his critical art, but you should do at least the two mediums. Oh, sorry, that wasn't it. Missing that combo right there. Wow. Trying to do his. There we go. I don't know why I wasn't getting that. Really bad. There we go. Got stand medium punch into crouch medium punch into medium inferno into super. That's his most damaging if you do it from both mediums, but you also have that scissor kick into. Have scissor kick into super. There we go. Seem to have some trouble with the super today, I don't know why. But hey, we all have trouble with input sometimes. In the corner, you can't do this. You can't do the Psycho Blast, but if you get a medium, you can just do medium Psycho Blast into super as well. Okay, so far, that's all the combos that you have with Bison's medium punch. Medium attacks, I'm sorry. You already know, I already was clear. Remember when you use medium kick, you can't combo into his medium or round or heavy versions of his scissor kick or infernos, neither EX, only EX scissor kick. So you should always go for the low special moves. Now I'm gonna move on to his heavy attacks so that you can see what combos and links he has after a stand roundhouse, stand fierce, and everything else, okay? Bison, his standing heavy punch is the one that you can cancel off. You can do this far or close because in this game there are no proximity normals. So with Bison, you can do stand fierce into, you can cancel his standing high punch to all versions of his Psycho Inferno, all of the versions of his Psycho Blast, including EX. You can actually do the EX one, even though it comes out slow. The hit stun of the standing fierce is enough for you to combo it. And all his scissor kicks. His heavy scissor kick, you can combo off a standing fierce. So, other combos that he has is his standing roundhouse. his stand heavy kick. You can link either his standing short into low scissor kick or standing short into EX scissor kick, sorry. But his go-to combo after the stand roundhouse is not actually doing standing short, it's actually crouching medium for more damage. Sorry. Because it gives you more damage. See? So you can do with Bison, you can do stand roundhouse, crouch medium punch into medium scissor kick, or you can do stand roundhouse, crouching medium punch into medium inferno, or his EX versions, whichever. If you want the damage, you just go for his medium version. And you can do his, this actually doesn't push you too far, so you can actually do medium cycle blast as well. You can do stand roundhouse, crouching medium punch into EX cycle blast. Another normal he has, which is a heavy attack, is a command normal, which is his down forward heavy punch, which he does this. This actually has more range. This has more range than his standing fierce, because he moves forward a bit. And it actually lets you combo, I'm gonna show you the combos right now. You can do down forward heavy punch into a low, any low actually. See? Or you can do his maximum damage, which would be down forward heavy punch into crouching medium punch. And you can just do the same combos that we did with medium earlier in the episode. If you want the damage, you go for medium into EX. Well, that's pretty much his heavy combos, pretty much. You have stand roundhouse into crouching medium, right? And you have down forward fierce into crouching medium. So those are your go-to combos when you land them. He also has another combo, but it's a counter hit because he has a target combo, which is this one. Stand medium punch is into down forward heavy punch. If you land that in counter hit, it combos. Okay, now we're gonna go to Bison's counter hit combos. I'm gonna do the same in the same order that I did with his basic combos. I'm gonna go from low attacks, medium attacks, and then his heavy attacks. So the first thing I'm going to show are his links after his low attacks. The counter hit, the way it works in this game is that it gives you additional frame advantage. So combos you would not normally be able to combo, you can combo them if they're on counter hit. In Bison's case, you have his lows, right? You have crouching low punch into crouching strong, into crouching medium punch. You also have stand low kick into crouching strong, and you have standing low punch into crouching medium punch. His crouching low kick, you can't do a medium punch after his low kick, but you can do his standing low kick, because this normally cannot combo. So you can do that. Yeah, that doesn't hit. But like, that's if it's counter hit only, because normally your combo would be if it's a non-counter hit. But see, now you already know that after a jab, you get this. And if you get this, sorry, I didn't land it there. There you go. As you can see, those are the combos you can get off a counter hit low attack. Now I'm going to move on to his medium attacks in counter hit, which has same frame advantage. So we're just going to check those out. Okay, here we go with his counter hit combos from medium attacks. His standing medium will actually give you a lot more combos when you land it on counter hit. You can do stand medium into crouching medium kick. That's one of his combos. So you can do into low scissor kick. Remember, you can't combo any of the other scissor kicks after the medium kick. Exactly. And you also have stand medium punch into standing medium kick. So if you land it really far, see, this wouldn't hit really far, but this, you can actually, if you're pretty far, you can do that. Because sometimes where the crouching medium kick won't reach, you'll get the stand medium kick, like around here. See? And around here, see, that hits. You also have, remember when I mentioned earlier his target combo, his down forward, his medium, stand medium punch into down forward heavy punch? Well, in counter hit, it combos. So if you get a counter hit stand medium, you do the target combo, and that's still, and down forward heavy punch lets you combo into another medium, into crouching medium punch, so you get a full combo right after it. Ah, did roundhouse scissor kick, my bad. See, that was medium scissor kick. So you get more damage if you land the counter hit. His other combos are crouching medium into a low. See? His crouching low punch doesn't reach. So you can do either that, because after a low punch you don't have much. You could do that or psycho blast, I think. See? Or you can go for a short and get the scissor kick. Another thing, which is different here, his forward, his standing forward doesn't really push you far if he hits you close. So, well, that plus in Street Fighter 4, you have to be far to get it, so. But see, you can do a, you can do any of his low attacks right after the medium kick. You can do a medium kick into crouching low kick. But crouching low kick, you can't cancel it, so it's not worth anything right there. You can do standing jab right after, you can do crouching jab right after, or standing low kick. It's a shame you can't do strong, but there you go. As you can see, those are his counter hit combos from his medium attacks. If you want, if you manage to confirm the counter hit, then you can convert the damage into a lot more. So that's what you can do with him. Those are all his combos in counter hit from medium attacks. So now I'm gonna go over his heavy attacks, including the fact that some of his heavy attacks have the crush counter effect. So I'm gonna explain the crush counter and what you can do right after a crush counter hit. So we're gonna go for that now. Let's see what we can get. Okay, oh, and before going to the heavy attacks, I forgot one combo with the mediums. You can also do stand medium punch into stand medium punch. Stand medium punch into stand medium kick, stand medium punch into stand medium punch, and stand medium punch into crouching medium kick. Those are his counter hit combos from a stand medium punch. That plus the target combo that I explained earlier. So now we're gonna go for his heavy attacks. Stand heavy punch doesn't give you frame advantage for anything, and it does push you pretty far, so you can't get anything off of it. Crouching high punch doesn't give you frame advantage either, so you can't really get anything off that either. So his moves for counter hit are, which actually end up being crush counter moves, are his standing roundhouse. See, as you can see, it has the crush counter effect. And his down forward fierce, which is his other crush counter move. Okay, so I'm gonna explain the combos that you get after a crush counter hit. If you get standing roundhouse, you can just walk up, do another one. Do another standing heavy kick, and then you can go for his normal combo, which I explained earlier when it was on non-counter hit combos, which is a crouching strong into either medium punch flame, or you can do it into medium scissor kick. Or medium psycho blast, actually, because you're close enough, so you can just... Let me see if I can get it. Nope, you have to walk up too much. So yeah, so the best bet is doing his medium flame. Go for that, because you have to walk up. But if you want to be more optimal, that's not really his most damaging combo off a crush counter roundhouse. You can also do crush counter roundhouse into sweep, you can do that. If you do crush counter, you can just do his basic combo, but that's not really worth it because it's the same damage. Well, except for the fact that you land that counter hit. But his go-to combo, if you get a crush counter roundhouse, is down forward fierce. You do stand roundhouse, down forward fierce, into medium inferno. Or medium scissor kick, whichever you find gives you the better options at the moment. You can do that. Now, another combo he has is his other crush counter move, which is his down forward fierce. Right? After you land this, it depends. If you land it pretty close, you get the roundhouse. Right? You can do that. And you can do any of his basic combos off a medium punch, right? If you land his down forward fierce punch too far, this isn't gonna reach. So your best option is to do his standing fierce, because actually standing fierce has a lot of range. So you land this, then you do standing fierce into scissor kick, or, and you can do heavy scissor kick, which is the good part. So you can do heavy scissor kick, or you can do heavy psycho blast, or you can do heavy inferno, whichever you find is the most suiting for the situation that you want after the mix-up. You can actually, you can do that. What else can you do after the fierce? Those are pretty much all his combos, like right after the down forward fierce. You can do down forward fierce into that, and you can do, I think, this too. Let me see if I can get this one. Sorry. Oh, by the way, yeah, his slide is also crush counter if it hits on counter hit. Sorry, I'm trying to... Yeah, you can do that. You can also do stand roundhouse into EX Devil's Reverse, which is really not worth it. It's just for show. If you want to like kill him with something like... And then you can do low scissor kick. But don't do that, unless if you just want to be a jerk. No, just kidding, if you just want to have fun with it. So now those are his counter hit slash crush counter combos. Now I'm just gonna move on to his thing that we call meaty attacks. That is, well, it's a familiar term. It's on a lot of different games. It's on Street Fighter 3, mostly Street Fighter 3, Third Strike. You would hear a lot the terms meaty. In Street Fighter 4, meaties are apparent as well, and they are usable. But here in this game, they are really important for either new combos, because you can combo things that you can normally combo off. So I'm gonna show some meaty combos and some actually interesting combos that meaty that maybe people have not seen. So let's see. Okay guys, now I'm gonna show you a section that is actually, to me, it's really fun because it gets me to find setups and able to get meaty attacks. So I really like that section. So I'm just gonna show you, Bison has a lot of meaty combos that he can pull off. I put the character to have no guard, because since I'm gonna do the meaty attacks on his wake up, if you put for him to block after the first attack, then he's gonna automatically block. Hey, first attack, yeah, by the way. Anyways, I'm gonna show that right now, okay? This is one of his meaty combos. You can do crouching strong into his standing short if it's a meaty. Oh, but it's on counter hit. Let me change that, I'm sorry. Here we go. Let me see if I get the strong. There we go. Crouching strong into any of his lows. You can do standing jab, you can do crouching jab, whichever comes first. This one's really hard to land, actually. Okay. But you can land it right after. See? Another of his combos is stand strong into stand strong in meaty. This one I have a reset actually, so I'll do that one. Yeah, I'm gonna do the specific reset. I need him to quick rise. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now we got it. See, that was a meaty standing strong and you get the target combo. So I'm just gonna show all the combos you can do like after a meaty standing strong. So here we go. You can get standing medium kick. Did that one wrong. Missed that right there. You get his target combo. You also get his another standing medium, actually. Might not hit on Ken, actually. I think those two might not reach, actually. I'm sorry. But if you land it meaty on a close, see? You get also the crouching forward as well. Let me see if I can land it. There we go. And now the one that I like the most is his close roundhouse, actually. Let's see if I can get that one. There we go. So you get either standing strong, crouching forward, or standing forward. They all come out in 7. One more. There we go. Now we all have. Now, the funnest one out of all of them is actually... I already did crouching strong. The funnest one of all is actually this one. This one I'm going to show in a tech video later on. It's meaty scissor kick, and you actually can combo right after it. So you can get a standing short right after a meaty scissor kick, or you can do that. Either you can also do low cycle blast, actually. See, you got a full combo, so if you get it, you actually can max the damage. Oh, that, I'm sorry, that doesn't combo. Sorry, that doesn't combo. Into EX scissor kick. So that's pretty neat, but that means actually that the scissor kick, if they block it, it's less unsafe, because when you hit with meaty attacks, you got more frame advantage, and if the moves are unsafe, they're less unsafe if they're meaty. So that's pretty much all of the things that you can do after a meaty attack. I think you can also do... No, actually, this is really hard, because this doesn't lift you up. I'm sorry. That's only in V-Trigger that you can do actually a combo if you land the meaty one. So that's pretty much all the meaty combos that he has, pretty sure. And now I'm gonna move on to some jump-in attacks, his jumping combos, and combos after a double's reverse. Okay, now we're gonna go for some jumping attacks and some double reverse combos, because a lot of people know about the double reverse, but they don't really know what combos you can do right after, so I'm gonna show a few of those. Basic jumping attacks, this is just going to be a combination of what I already explained when you're on the ground, his normal combos on the ground after a jump in. So you can do jump fierce, jump heavy punch, stand heavy kick, crouching medium punch into flame, or you can do a cross up medium kick into two mediums. I already showed this. You can do that. You can do this. But now I'm gonna show what you do with his jump medium punch, which actually gives you juggle properties when you land it. It's this move right here. In other Street Fighter games, especially Street Fighter 4, you could throw both medium punches, even if they didn't hit. But in this game, you can only do the second medium punch only if the first one hits, which is kind of a drag, but it's what it is. So you get two medium punches into... You actually can land both hits of the scissor kick if you do it later. See? And if you do it higher, you can actually do medium scissor kick for more damage. And if you really want more damage, you can do EX scissor kick. It does a lot more damage. You can do medium punch into Inferno. You have to be careful when you do the Inferno. See that thing that just happened? If you do it too close, you're gonna cross them up. See? And if you do it far enough, you can actually do the Fierce Inferno. I did it too. See? If you just want to be sure, then just go for EX Inferno. Because even if it crosses up, it's going to hit because it hits on both sides. You can do also your low Psycho Blast, your heavy Psycho Blast. That one does a lot of damage. Or your EX Psycho Blast. And if you have your super, you can do super into alternate Psycho Crusher. The move that I'm kind of sad he doesn't have it in this game, but well, what can you do? Oh, another thing you can do with his medium punches, I didn't say it. He has this in Street Fighter 4 as well. You can land one, then two. Let me do it right. And then do the scissor kick. Like if you land it pretty high, you can do three mediums. That's pretty cool. See, the hitbox on this is a lot smaller. And you can also do super. Oh, and you can do this. Let me see if I can do it. That actually hits head stomp. See? And if you do this pretty low, I saw Desk do this, but this is really hard. Let me see if I can do it. Missed it right there. You can land that. See? And I think you can actually do the scissor kick as well right after, but it's really hard. Anyways, don't try that one. It's really impractical, so don't do it. Do the other ones that I just showed. You also have, after the strong, I'm pretty much sure that's it. Oh, if you land one strong, you can actually just do resets. You can do that. And if you want a crossover, you can just do... See, and you can cross them up. And you can also do meaties, like you can do this meaty, the meaty that I did earlier. See? And you can do it a bit later. And it does meaty. Let me see if I can get it. See? And that's actually plus on block, so if you land it on block, they can't punish you or they can't attack. In fact, you can throw a normal and, you'll beat it out. Another thing that he has now is his Devil's Reverse combos. You just put him in crouch. Now, Devil's Reverse has juggle properties. You can do a low kick scissor kick right after the Devil's Reverse. You can do EX scissor kick, does more damage. You can do a low psycho blast. And you can actually do infernos, but it's if you land it like hella meaty. So let's try to do it. See if I can get at least one. Yeah, it's really hard. Yeah. I'll show it in another video. You can land it a bit more on Chun-Li. Yeah, dude. Yeah. Yeah, there we go. It's really hard, don't try it. I'd rather you just do this. And I think that if you land in the corner, you can also do the super. Let me see if I can get it. You can do that. That's in the corner, because like if you do it on this in the middle, depending on how it hits, you can't land it. So let me see if I can... See, he's too far. And you can also do... You can do that, or you can cancel the scissor kick as well. I didn't get the scissor kick, but you can cancel the first hit of the scissor kick into super and it'll hit. Let's just dash the whole stage. Sometimes I'm better on the other side. See? You can do that. Okay, so that's so far for Devil's Reverse. His EX Devil's Reverse does two hits. See? Oh, and this this move is a whole overhead. You have to block it standing, so it's really good. And you can do really low if you do EX, so that's really good. See, you can do that. So you can do low mix-up into overhead. And it's really hard to block. See, since you can do it so low on the ground. See? Okay, now I'm gonna go for some meaty counter hit combos, and then after that we're gonna go straight into V-trigger, which is the funnest part of Bison. I'm gonna go back to meaties because I forgot to mention what is the meaty counter hits. That's actually something really interesting as well. Because if you know your opponent is mashing on wake up or trying to stop your offense, well then you can always catch him with, since you're already doing a meaty, if he's doing attacks as well, well then you're gonna catch him with a meaty counter hit. That's even worse. If you land a meaty counter hit, you have a lot more frame advantage. So you have frame advantage if you get on counter hit. You have frame advantage if you get on meaty. If you have it on both, you get double the frame advantage. So it's even better. So one of his links would be this one. Stand strong into stand high kick. That actually does not combo in any other way besides counter hit meaty. And you also have his, remember the scissor kick combo that I showed? You can actually do this. Ah, oh, missed it right there. See? Let me show that combo once again. Ah, didn't get it meaty. There you go. Okay. And, but the best one is when you land meaty, counter hit, scissor kick, low kick. That's even better. Because after that, you get a lot more. You get, let me show it. You can actually do his stand strong, which is even better. So let's just do that. Yeah, that combo, just give me 1 sec, I'm gonna combo it soon. Kinda lag. Oh, Jesus Christ. There we go, finally. Well, that one's a hard one, but those are his meaty counter hit combos that he can do. The scissor kicks ones look like the most fun, actually, but they're hard. They're really hard to do, and they're kind of predictable. So maybe, depends on the character. The person's already mashing, he's gonna get hit, and if you do it, then you get to style on him, so that's even, it's pretty fun. Okay, well, now we're gonna go, we're here with his V-trigger combos. I'm gonna show you more or less what Bison can do in V-trigger. Now, something very important to know is that his scissor kicks are slower and his infernos are faster, which means he can actually combo crouching medium punch into fierce inferno. As you can see, this is 4 hits. And that's 5. I think I still have him on counter hit. Let me get off the counter hit. Let me put him to block after the first attack. There we go. And, but here's the problem, see? Medium into medium scissor kick doesn't combo anymore. You have to do low scissor kick if you do a medium, and if you do fierce, you cannot do roundhouse scissor kick because it doesn't combo. You have to do either medium or low versions of scissor kick. So keep that in mind when you're in V-trigger, because sometimes you might fail a combo, because I did it even earlier, I've done it before, that I sometimes do crouching medium to medium scissor kick and it doesn't combo in V-trigger. So that's a mistake that a lot of people make, so try not to make it, okay? So his combos, I'm gonna go the same version as when I did with counter hits, as I did with his normal combos. I'm gonna go combos with low attacks, combos with medium attacks and V-trigger, and combos with heavy attacks. Now with low attacks, you got this. You got his, let me just do this. You got crouching short into crouching jab into psycho blast, and you can still psycho blast into his EX scissor kick. Or you can do crouching jab. You can do that one. Sorry. It's actually good if you confirm it off anything. Another of his combos is in the corner, and this one, after a low, you get more damage. So I'm gonna show you this one really quick. So if you get the, if you get that, right? You do this. You just walk up. That's after a low. You can actually do low, low, psycho blast, EX inferno into EX head stomp, or you can do problem with his dash. That didn't combo. Let me just waste the meter for a second. Okay. You can actually do that one too, which is EX Inferno into EX Scissor Kick. Actually does more damage. See? You can't even do low into low. There you go. Now I'm gonna show you some of his combos in medium with medium attacks. He has crouching medium punch into low scissor kick into EX Inferno. Because like I said, you can't do the medium scissor kick. Doesn't hit. So you do this. To EX Inferno, and you can actually, for more damage, you can actually do, you can do EX Inferno into EX Scissor Kick, or you can do to EX Head Stomp, does a lot of good damage for 2 meters. You can also do his crouching medium punch into a normal Psycho Inferno, because they all combo, and then you can do EX Scissor Kick right after. See, so you can do something like, and you get a lot of damage. So you can do all his basic combos, like anything into Inferno still hits, anything into Psycho Blast, his Psycho Blast properties didn't change. Actually, they did, sorry. The only move that is actually slower is his Scissor Kick, but his Psycho Blast, you can do Fierce Psycho Blast after a medium and it does combo. And you can do his Inferno after a medium and any version does combo as well. A thing that you do need to know, I didn't mention this, is that his EX Inferno is actually slower. Different from when he's not in V-Trigger. This usually combos, but when he's in V-Trigger, it's slower. So you can't combo right after it. You can only combo if you land the Fierce, okay? So very important note to know that, okay? See, the startup for all his Psycho Blast and Infernos are relatively the same. They actually do the same damage. All the Infernos, no matter what punch button, there always will be 4 hits, and they're always gonna do 177 damage. Like, it doesn't matter if you do low, or if you do medium, or if you do heavy, because the damage is the same. So that's something that you should know. Now, combos with heavy attacks for V-Trigger is basic ones. You got standing high punch into medium scissor kick into EX Inferno and EX Scissor Kick. Does good damage. You could also do, let's put him up. Oh, I did it too early. Let me waste the V trigger for a sec. There you go. Yeah, there we go. I landed it. That's actually the combo in which you can land all 3 of his EX. You have to do Scissor Kick into EX Psycho Blast into EX Inferno, and then EX Head Stomp. But you have to do the EX Head Stomp while the Inferno is still hitting, because if not, it's not going to hit. But that's if you want to waste all your meter, actually. It does good damage. If it's for the kill, go for it. If not, don't go for it. Just use 2 meters, because it does a lot of damage.
The other one combo that he has is standing high punch. Oh, sorry.
Stand roundhouse. Yeah, stand roundhouse into crouching medium, into inferno, into EX scissor kick, or you can also do... See? You can do stand roundhouse as well. Let me do this. And you can cancel that too. Same thing. So basically most of his combos, you have to be really aware of the difference in his frame data when he's in V-trigger and when he's not in V-trigger. Like I said, scissor kicks are slower, so the combos that usually hit when he's not in V-trigger don't hit when it comes to scissor kicks, but his combos that don't hit with Inferno and Psycho Blast when he's not in V-trigger, they hit on V-trigger, so you have to know the difference. It's really important that you do, because if not, you're gonna be dropping combos and you're gonna get mad and salty. So after that, now I'm gonna go for the last bit of the V trigger is combos that are into V trigger, which are the most damaging combos of all. Actually makes you, lets you be creative. You can actually do, there's a lot of combos that you can do with him when he's in V trigger. I am gonna show you a few, and I'm gonna show you the most damaging out of all, the better conversions. So let's just go for a quick bit with these. Okay, so here we go with his combos into the trigger. This is how you can actually extend your combos and get some extra damage. He has a huge number of the trigger combos because he can actually combo moves that he can cancel moves that usually would not cancel into the trigger, like his down forward heavy punch. You can cancel his close roundhouse. You can cancel his sweep, his slide. You can cancel his slide as well. So we're just going to go with a few of them right now. I'm going to do the first one as a crush counter. See, that's medium scissor kick into... When you do the scissor kick that I did right there was medium scissor kick, but after you do V-trigger cancel after a medium scissor kick, you cannot combo his strong. You can only combo his standing light kick. So let me put here so that I can block, so you guys can know the difference. Now we're gonna restart again. So if you're gonna do a combo, then if you wanna do a combo that's even more damaging, you're gonna do stand roundhouse and stand fierce. See, that was crush counter roundhouse into stand fierce into roundhouse scissor kick, V trigger, and you can combo his crouching strong, you can combo crouching strong into his inferno, and the inferno you can then link the EX scissor kick. Another one he has is... Sorry. And do that. Or you can do his extended combo, which is using all 3EX. You can do the same combos that I showed earlier in V-Trigger. Pretty much whatever you want to do. The only thing you have to focus on are the starters, because when you cancel V-Trigger from a scissor kick, you have to know how much the advantage is. See, I did low scissor kick. I did medium scissor kick. Even if you do low scissor kick, you can still do the standing short right after. It's only with roundhouse scissor kick that you get enough hit stun to allow you to do a crouching strong. Another one is crush counter. It's that one, crush counter, down forward fierce, stand fierce. Roundhouse scissor kick, V trigger, crouching strong. Low kick into EX Inferno, crouching strong into low kick scissor kick into EX Inferno into EX scissor kick. You can also do... Sorry. If it's EX Psycho Blast, EX Inferno into another EX Psycho Blast, or you can do... All 3 meters. It's really, that's really not worth it. when you're already doing so much damage, so don't really go for that actually. See, that's one meter, and it's just enough damage. It's really enough damage. So you can also do another combo that he has for V trigger. Ah, you remember the meaty setup that I did with the scissor kick? Oh, this is fun. You're gonna like this one. Oh, I have to take off the guard. I'm sorry. Let me do it. Oh, and it's on counter hit, so I have to change that too. Sorry. Trigger, and you can do that. And if you land his medium scissor kick, I think it is. Let me see if it was medium. I think you can do it with medium. Let me just make sure because I don't remember. Yeah, I know that if you do meaty scissor kick and you V trigger it, you can do a strong. Combo right there. Maybe try that again. See? You can do a strong. That is not, that's not confirmable actually, so. It's just good to know. I mean, I guess just want you guys to know all the possibilities that Bison has when he's in V trigger. You also have, when he's in V trigger, you can also do. You can do that. Let me waste the meter for a quick sec. See, if you're close to the corner, that actually hits. There you go. Waste the meter. And here we go. Or you can actually do this. Ah, I wasted the V trigger right there. Yeah, it doesn't hit. And I'm already gonna waste my V trigger, so just waste it really quick. And let's just do one more. I would recommend you do that because that does the most damage. And out of all his V-trigger combos, you can just pretty much like, just get away with everything. That's a low confirm, it's good damage. If you're gonna go for the kill, go for it. It's a pretty good combo. And what else would I recommend? Oh, you can actually do Infernos as well. Doesn't hit as well because the juggle property goes when you do his normal inferno. When you cancel, you can only do one more EX. You can't do repeated EX. See, even if I do the psycho blast, I can't do anything else. Let's do one more just so you guys can see. That's V-Trigger for you. Like, actually, he has like a lot of stuff in V-Trigger. So you can just have a lot of fun with him. Like I said, you can cancel moves that normally would not cancel. Like this one. And you can combo Fierce right after. So if you by any chance manage to get a counter hit strong into the counter hit, That's just too much damage. So let's just put counter hit for a sec so that you guys can see how much you could get off that. Because this is that's the good thing about V trigger, because look. You can cancel that, make it safe. You can cancel this. Okay.
crouching fierce, you can cancel into V trigger, and his down forward fierce, you can cancel into V trigger, and his standing strong. These are moves that you can't cancel into anything else, but you can cancel them into V trigger. So if you land this, yay, more damage. Let's see what else we got. Two meters, and it did more or less the same damage. So I would just recommend, I would recommend this combo actually. You do this. That was not the combo that I wanted to do. I wanted to do, oh, now I know what I wanted to do. Spend only 1 meter and it's relatively good damage. So I would just recommend you do that one. And that's pretty much it. It's just really good to be aware of what you can do in V-Trigger and whatnot. This hits so many people, it's ridiculous. And if you want the super, because now you can actually do, you can actually do this. Oh! Just remembered one thing. This one's really good. This one's really good. You guys are gonna like this one. Something very important. I'm not gonna go in depth with this because I'm gonna do another. This will be covered in another episode. I'm going to go into conversions. This is when you actually land something and you can actually convert it into something even better. So this is one of his good conversions. It's really important. If you land his Devil's Reverse, you do a little kick scissor kick. If you have the critical art and V-Trigger, you can just V-Trigger cancel into super, and you get that damage off just one Devil's Reverse that you managed to land in the corner. That's only in the corner, actually, so you can't land it anywhere else, but it's good to know. Since this is an overhead, if the person you're playing doesn't know that this move is an overhead, it's a free combo. Because really, a lot of people, it's never been an overhead. It was never an overhead in Street Fighter 4. It's an overhead now, so it's worth it. And that's pretty much it. I think that I could cover it all. I'm gonna do a more in-depth video because he has a lot of different combos depending on the situation that you're in and what you want to convert depending on the situation. With V-Trigger, there's a lot of stuff you can do, a lot of fun stuff, and I'm gonna make a better video that's just a compilation of all of his combos into V-Trigger. So there you have it. That concludes episode 2 of Shadowloo Bootcamp. Hope you guys enjoyed the video and you guys get a lot of knowledge with all the combos that we gave for Bison. Make sure to subscribe to our channel, Gamers Grid TV, where we will be uploading all of the episodes for Shadowloo Bootcamp, as well as additional videos, which are tech update videos. Like if you saw the reset at the beginning of the video, well, there are a lot more videos to come of that. So make sure to subscribe to Gamers Grid TV. And you know what? As a thank you for the community that's actually following, tomorrow, you're gonna click on this link, and you're gonna see a new video, which is actually a tech video for resets, similar to the ones that you guys saw at the beginning. So make sure to subscribe to Gamers Grid TV, so you'll be the first to get the notification when that video's up. And trust me, the tech is good, so you might as well check on it, okay? And another thing that I wanna ask you guys, what did you think of the video, of these episodes? I would appreciate some feedback, comment on the section below. Also, what characters would you like us to go over? Like, we're going over Bison right now. There are a few more episodes for Bison, but maybe on the next one, we'll be checking other characters. So we'll make a little quick guide with at least 4 characters so that you guys can vote and say which characters you would like us to do a rundown and explain and go through pretty much everything that we did with Bison, do it for every other character, because that's what we want to do. We want to help you level up. We want to help you find everything with your character, and that's what it is. So join us in Shadowloo Bootcamp. Be part of the movement.